Rest assured, you will all have all you want to eat. There's plenty to eat here. Royce and Pam Money have paid for this meal out of their own pockets, just put right out of their wallet. So any leftovers, we'll send to England where Royce and Pam are. While the dinners continue to be served, there are some things that we need to do, and there are some people that we need to honor. And the foremost of those are Royce and Pam Money, who I think we have visible. Okay, there we are. Yeah. Royce and Pam, can you hear us okay?
Yes.
Yes, but fortunately, Jack, we can't see you.
Really? That's a shame. I'm looking particularly good today. Your son-in-law asked whether or not you were wearing pants. You are fully dressed, aren't you?
Sure, since Ron Martin's in the room with us.
Well, I certainly hope so. But we do see your head and shoulders, and Pam, we see you guys. Tell us why you're in England.
Well, I'm teaching a course over here, Survey of Church History, and to be quite frank, this is the first real job I've had in over 20 years. I'm working.
Can you say anything in British to us?
I'd rather not.
Well, you can't see us, but we have a room full of folks in the Hunter Welcome Center and the McCaleb rooms, which you know quite well. We have a room full of friends, of missionaries, of family members, of students who are here. We're here for a variety of reasons, obviously. We're here to celebrate missions at ACU. We're here to talk about the future and celebrate the past. But one of the most important things that we're here to do today is to honor the two of you. We recognize that your involvement, your leadership, your presence has made a significant difference, not just in the training of missionaries at ACU, but in the kingdom. In your role as a faculty member, in your role as the vice president for academic affairs, and in your long role as the president of the university, Royce, you have shown considerable vision. You've made courageous decisions. You have provided an empowerment to not just the College of Biblical Studies, but to the entire university to think broadly, to think globally, and have provided the resources to do that. Pam, you've not just been a partner in this, but you also have exhibited your own vision for the world. You have been a source of encouragement to missionaries around the world, and you specifically have served in a role of equipping and training missionaries, and a key role for a long time in providing the counseling, help, and the assessment that is necessary for us to be sending the kind of teams that we send. It's hard to imagine two individuals whose influence has been greater for the kingdom and for missions, and certainly for the Hallward Institute for Missions at ACU, than the two of you. And we wish to express to you our thanks. Your daughter Jennifer and your son-in-law Brad to come up. That was really a tanky comment that you made to me, and you, about your father-in-law, that is. And you knew better than to say that. They're going to receive something, Pam and Royce, on your behalf. There is a gift here that we expect you to give to them when they return. And so I will describe it to them so that they will know when it's on your mantle.
Yeah. We can see you now.
Oh, can you? Okay, good. How do I look?
Not the same.
We'll show this to you. This, we want to present to you on behalf of the Holbert Institute for Missions. This is more than just a candle. One of the North American mission majors, Austin Brown, who's now a marriage and family therapy student, so that will connect to both of your worlds, has designed this candle holder. And I'm going to ask you to hold that. Okay, hold that. Thank you so much. This says, you are full of light in the Lord. And it is a picture of the globe at the base. And this candle is an indication of our recognition of your commitment for missions and your heart for the world. And on behalf of the Holbert Institute and on behalf of Advent Christian University, we're going to give this to Jennifer and to Brad on your behalf with our deepest appreciation. We love you guys much. Thanks for being a part of this celebration, and I assume you're going to continue to stay and witness the events, or are you going to go to sleep?
I'd like to say something, Jack.
Oh! If you must.
First of all, we must give glory to God for what has taken place at ACU, and I want to be careful to do that, but also give thanks for the Holbert family, and particularly for Joanne Holbert, a longtime friend of ours, dear friend, and she was a role model and an inspiration for this institute for a number of years, and there were other donors who came in to the vision and helped us to be where we are today. It was truly a remarkable campaign. And from a fundraising standpoint, I hope everybody understands this. It was easy money to raise because the vision and the mission was right. And so my gratitude to the Lord first, to all who made this possible. And I just hope and pray that we'll bless generations to come for the sake of Jesus Christ.
Thank you both. Belinda is here representing the Holbert family, Belinda Harmon, and Barbara and Barry Packer are here representing the Packer family, whose contribution was significant. I don't know if we can get their picture here at this table to show them, but yeah, there they are. Points. And so we also recognize them here for their contributions. Royce and Pam, thank you both so very, very much.
Thank you.
For the past 10 years, Dr. Sonny Guild has been the director of the Holbert Institute for Missions. I can hardly imagine a leader whose vision has been so far-sighted and whose energy has been so constant and whose heart has been so gentle and whose eyes have been so global than Sonny, who, along with Eunice, served for well over a decade in Kenya, as well as serving a church in Oregon for a similar length of time. That vision has largely propelled the Holbert Institute to become what it is today, one of the largest and most effective missions training organizations, certainly as a part of a university anywhere in our fellowship. We're grateful, Sonny, for your work. And while I know that you have an introduction to make of the video, we're going to honor you today for your 10 years of work and leadership. And so join me on the stage, if you would. Sonny, thank you so much for your vision, for your partnership, for welcoming the kingdom of God, for training so many students so well. Sonny's not retiring. He's not going anywhere. He will continue to teach missions and to work closely with our missions teams. But as he completes his 10th year in directing the Halbert Institute, we want to give this to you, a globe, as you can see, with this inscription: the Halbert Institute for Missions, Director 2000-2010, gentle spirit, mentor, teacher, encourager, friend. Sonny, thank you.
Well, I want to thank Jack and everyone, I guess, that's a part of Halbert for that honor and recognition. These past 10 years have been 10 years full of joy and doing work that really has been at the heart of my life, nearly all of my life. It's been good to be a part of something that you've seen it grow. I've seen a process develop and mature for training God's kingdom workers. And I will admit to you that the maturity that has come in this training process is because of the good men and women that I've been working with, who have been a part of the Halbert Institute. It's just amazing to have witnessed the contributions that those individuals have made to a process that I think has resulted in remarkable ways of bringing women and men into position of joining God in what he is doing in their lives and around the world. Now, for the next about 18 minutes, you're going to see a documentary. And in these 18 minutes, as best we can, we're going to tell the history of missions at ACU. Now, that's a challenge. In putting this together, I felt a bit like the author of Hebrews, in Hebrews chapter 11, where you just run out of time to mention all the names that need to be mentioned. But I think you will enjoy seeing this vision of missions in ACU that began at the very origins, beginnings of ACU. So many names, so much good has been done because of God's grace and his blessings. So please watch, enjoy, and celebrate with us.
Halbert Institute and training of missionaries at ACU is a part of a great partnership. We have partnerships with a number of other mission training and mission sending organizations. It's important for us not to assume that we're acting alone. Many of those representatives of some of those organizations are here with us today. Having the partnership, Belinda, with you and your family has been a rich and meaningful thing for us. Barbara, having a partnership with you and your family has also been a meaningful thing for us. The generosity of your resources have meant a huge amount, have played significantly in what has been done to welcome the kingdom of God throughout the world. But there's also a partnership with a number of other individuals.
There are folks here in this room who either are or were faculty members teaching missions. And so missions, said AC, has been a part of a rigorous faculty work, training undergraduate, and one of the few graduate missions programs in North America, as well as a number of missions coordinators or, in the past, missionaries in residence. I'm going to ask all of you who either currently are or have been a faculty member or a missionary in residence or missions coordinator at ACU, if you would please to stand. And then I'm going to ask if you are a past trainee of the Hallbread Institute, if you've been sent by ACU to do missions, or are currently on a team preparing to go, would you please stand? Thank you all, and especially for these former students who are now doing missions or these current students getting ready to be sent. If you would seek them out and give them a word of encouragement, that would be great. I'm going to ask Chris Flanders, who is beginning this fall, the director of the Hallbread Institute, to come and to share a vision for the future. Chris and Kara and their kids were a part of the work in Chiang Mai, Thailand for a number of years. Chris is a faculty member and as a part of the Hallbread Institute has meant a huge amount for reimagining the future of missions at ACU. Chris Flanders.
It really is a distinct honor to watch that video and see the long thread of missional commitment that stretches all the way back to the very beginnings of ACC and those early days. Those pictures were something. And I'm distinctly honored to stand here among my former colleagues, many of whom are still in the Abilene area. I see Gaston and Jan Tarbett. I'm so glad to see you. And the Brooms, of course, the omnipresent missions power drives ACU. Actually, that's the Holy Spirit, isn't it, Wendell, I think. But Wendell's a close second. Just such a blessing to be here and a distinct honor. I want to, for a moment, just lead you looking forward. We've looked at the past, and I just want to rehearse a few things. It's been an amazing 10-year ride, a great 10 years, and I've been privileged to be here for part of that. Since 2000, and some of these were already hinted at or shown in the video, we've trained and sent out over 430 short-term interns to 47 different locations. We've trained close to 600 individuals for some form of missional or cross-cultural service, and 161 of those nearly 600 individuals trained have entered into long-term mission service of some kind. And of those 161, we've helped, been a part of training 11 multi-unit, multi-family teams. And I want to echo Royce's sentiment where he began, and we just want to give God the glory for this because without God, none of this would happen, and in fact, we're continually amazed that even with God, it does. As we look around the table during staff meetings and we talk about things, we just see how unbelievably fragile and weak we are, and yet God has blessed Hallbread in tremendous ways. It's been an amazing 10 years. I want to reiterate, I didn't know that that was the clip that they had put in the video, I'd forgotten that, but I want to reiterate that we are full of world-class people, and I look around and I see Larry Henderson and I see Gary Green and I see Kent Smith and I see Deborah Nickham and those who have been a part of Hallbread in the past as well. World-class people with world-class experience. I am amazed at what God has placed in our lap here at ACU. We've got an exceptional missional formational process that I'm really proud of. Now, we're working hard, even right now, aren't we, Sonny? We're working hard to look at that and to make it even better, because we know we can improve it, and we're always going to be working at that. But we're really profoundly happy and honored with the good process that we have right now in place for training individuals and teams. And all of that together, world-class people and a great exceptional process leads to world-class impact. And as you can see, we've talked about already, the different places that God has allowed us to partner with people to send and people to be in. In fact, some of those people are here right now. I know the Thompsons, who are sitting right over here, are here from Lima, Peru. And they're back looking for new congregational and financial sponsors. So Thompson's right here in the middle table. If you want to connect with them afterwards, on your table is a little card. Matt and Tish Harris, who are going to Australia, would love to connect with you. But these are just a number of the people that we've sent and are in the process of sending, and there's more happening right now. I see also at the back of the table the Binkleys, who have returned recently from Thailand for a visit. Actually, it's because of the Rangers and their soon-to-be playoff fun. So we're going to continue this excellent missional formation. We're going to continue the good things that God has blessed us and allowed us to participate in. But, as you already know, the world has changed. It's changing right now, even as we speak. Change is kind of the new normalcy, isn't it? And we could talk about all the different things that have changed, the socialized, the globalized flat world. Actually, it's more spiky with flat valleys, perhaps. But the internet, how that has changed things, social media, how that's changed connectivity and communication and recruiting. We live in a post 9/11 world, and that has significantly altered what we do and what we are even called as missionaries, missions and missionaries. But the church is changing, isn't it? We all know this. The church in the West is struggling in many places. I know that there are examples of flourishing and vibrancy, but there are also many, many examples of decline and problems, fear, nervousness, anxieties. At the same time, the church in the global South, in many places, is exploding, is vibrant. What does that mean? What does that mean for those who we, us in the West, who have traditionally thought of ourselves as the senders, the center of mission, sending out into the world, into the mission field? What does that mean for the concept of missions and missionary? A lot of people think that we have entered into a new missional era, a term I borrow from Pat Kiefert. We talk about this. What does that mean for Halbert? Well, I would love to have another half an hour, but I don't. Let me just in brief paint a sketchy picture of where we believe God is calling Halbert to go as we step forward. In fact, I'd like to introduce you now to Halbert 2.0. The first 10 years, maybe we can call Halbert 1.0, 20th century Halbert, and now a distinctly 21st century Halbert as we look forward. What does that look like? Well, one of the first things is that we at Halbert want to be and are going to be at the center of the missional university conversation. Many of you know, but let me remind us all that starting with Dr. Royce Money and now with Dr. Phil Schubert, we are in a university that is committed to being global and critical and missional. I sat next to Ed Matthews the very moment that that term was unveiled in a faculty meeting, and I leaned over to Dr. Matthews and said, could you have envisioned 20 years ago the president of our university standing up and saying we are a missional institution? And he just shook his head and he said, this is a new day. What does that mean? We don't completely know, but we do know that as we move forward, we want to be a blessing in resourcing that vision and helping the university lean into that. In fact, I like to think that here at ACU, we actually are the globe's largest mission sending agency. Because we've got 5,000 missionaries that we're training right now. We're even larger than the International Mission Board of the Southern Baptists, if you kind of count that way. Wow. That's what we're about. We want to resource. We want to walk alongside, come alongside, and journey with the different departments and the different academic units of the university, not to draw mission people into our fold, but to expend ourselves in missional energy to bless the rest of the school as we all are working at sending ourselves out into the world on a missional journey with God. Next. 2 years ago, we did a study, a project, where we interviewed church leaders across the globe and asked a really simple question. What would it look like if we were really partners with you? What would that be like to be in partnership with you in mission? And how could the Halbert Institute be a part of that and help you? We got really interesting information back. We kind of summarized and codified the results. And what we came up with was a distinct picture that, among other things, clearly indicated that there are people around the world who are desiring stronger partnership with institutions like ACU and Halbert. Now, we're not the only ones who see this, but we are trying to listen to God's leading as we formulate and understand what that means for us. But we're developing now a partnership, a network linked with leaders and churches throughout the globe where we can mutually inform and bless and receive blessings to help each other live into God's missional calling. And that's an exciting part, I think, of this next 10 years or however long God is going to allow us to continue to do this good work, the Global Missional Partners Project. We want here at Halbert to continue to be supporters and carers and mentors and coaches of those that we've already sent out, but also to expand and to allow the networks that we were just mentioning here and the global partners to be opportunities to bless missionaries, to care for missionaries. This is something that I know is close to Pam Money's heart. I see Dr. Carly Dodd, who's here, and the kind of resources that he's done in the past in his work and writing. We've got an amazing amount of resources here at ACU that would allow us to develop a center, to even perhaps have physical facilities where missionaries can come in, be housed, be cared for, be refreshed, and then sent back out. We hope and pray that that vision will soon come to a more formal fruition as we go forward. And finally, we're excited to think about the new possibilities of research. Now, not the type of research that you might immediately think of, statistics and numbers of churches in countries and baptisms, and although that's good and interesting and important to know, here we're thinking more about research that involves learning how we can all become missional outposts in our contexts. The type of research that leads to reconceiving of mission that is effective and appropriate in a new world. The kind of mission research that is forming globally linked communities of learning so that we can all mutually benefit together. We're going to continue to do the things that we have done. And we're excited about continuing to excel and lead as we go forward. And as Jack mentioned, there are a lot of organizations in here who are also doing similar sorts of things. I spent maybe an inordinate amount of time over the last day with Dan Bouchel, the new head of Mission Resource Network. Sorry about that, Pope Dan. A wonderful guy who we think a lot alike. And in fact, I'm saying many things that if you were at the breakfast yesterday for the Mission Resource Network, you heard similar things. A lot of us are working on all this, and we need each other to work together to make this reality. So there's more to come. We're excited about some announcements in the near future, and we hope that you'll pay attention and stay tuned as we go forward. But I just want to say that I'm really pleased to be a part of this community. and blessed to be a part of what God is doing here at ACU through Halbert. And I hope that you'll pray for us, and I hope that you'll encourage us and give us feedback. Let us know how we're doing. But I want to say, most of all, that as we look back upon the great things that God has done, we anticipate even greater things going forward. Thank you.
Phil, if you'll be making your way up to the front, thank all of you for being here. Deborah Nickum, thank you for all that you've done to put this event in place, and for the work that you do in supporting and in many ways leading what the Halbert Institute for Missions does. We want to offer an opportunity for our new president, the 11th president of Abilene Christian University, Dr. Phil Schubert, to say a last word or two and to lead us in a closing prayer. Phil also has a heart for missions and a heart for the world, and we're glad for this partnership, and we look forward to the days ahead, Phil, as we work together side by side with you. Dr. Phil Schubert.
Thank you for being here. What a great day. ACU's 21st century vision states that by 2020, ACU aspires to be the premier institution for the education of Christ-centered global leaders. That vision has four pillars that I was reminded of in Dr. Flanders' remarks, one of which is that we will educate students to be critical, global, and missional in their thinking. I think it gets to the heart of what we've heard about today and the way in which we're preparing students for the world ahead. You know, some have been pretty quick to point out that missional is not a word or it's not in the dictionary. And you know what? I am happy for us to define it. To forge the future of what this means and have that emanate from this campus with the leaders and the servants that have come through and gone out from this place is exciting. Our passion is to help students hear and prepare for what God has called them to do as they go out into the world to make a real difference. That's why we're here, and that's what we do every day. And whether that be in full-time ministry or mission work in a global field, or whether that be in a seat in one of the world's finest graduate schools anywhere across the country and around the world, we want them to be prepared. We want to put a passion on their heart to make a real difference for Jesus Christ and glorify Him with what they do. And I think that the future of the Halbert Institute will be instrumental in ensuring that not only those who go into full-time ministry and missions work are adequately prepared, but those students across all disciplines know how to go out into the world to make a difference. To those families, Halbert, Harmon, Packer, McGee, Brown, so many others whose heart and passion for this work has transformed what takes place here, we thank you. None of this could happen without your support, and it certainly, we will not achieve the great heights of what God has called us to in the future without your continued support. I can't wait to see what God does through our students and through so many of the faculty and staff who serve here as we move into the future. Let's pray. Father, thank you for this great day and for the reminder of the important work in which we're involved. Thank you for the lives of the young men and women who come here bright-eyed, eager to see and hear and understand your call for their lives. Give us wisdom, faithfulness, courage, and patience as we guide and direct them according to your will, that we will prepare them and open doors, bring forth enthusiasm and energy to allow them to go out into the world to make a difference, whether that be here in this community or on the other side of the world. Father, bless our efforts. Keep us focused on you and your word in all that we do. Walk with us. It's in your Son's holy name that we pray. Amen. Thank you.